Hello, good morning children. We are talking about the different agencies of the United Nations. The key agencies of United Nations are UNESCO, UNICEF, WHO, ILO, FAO and others like World Bank also we discussed. Now we are going to discuss about the two important agencies of the United Nations which are working under the Social and Cultural Organization, the one of the main organs of the UN. Okay, first one, the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. Quite a big name, but you should remember that. The United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, that is, in short, it is called UNESCO. Okay, now what is the work of UNESCO? The work of UNESCO is focusing on the improving education worldwide. It also protects the historical and cultural sites all over the world. So, improving education all over the world, bringing as children, as people become educated, naturally the development will be there. If people remain illiterate, as you know, illiterate means that they do not know how to read and write, then how can a nation or how can this world improve or develop or progress? So for the proper development and progress of the nation, proper education is needed. And so this is the work of improving the education system or whole, not only in one or two countries or some nations of the world, but worldwide. And also protects the historical and cultural sites. What are the historical and cultural sites? I just give you an example, like Taj Mahal. The Taj Mahal is one of the wonders of the world. It was built by Shahjahan and it is like, you know, a thing to be preserved, a monument to be preserved. Now, this type of historical or cultural sites, places which are very old and has a, you know, great historical background in it, they are protected because these are our heritage, this is our pride. And there are different historical and cultural sites all over the world. They are taken care, and you know, this organization, they actually, they find out which are the cultural sites or heritage sites, and they name them and they do some work to protect the heritage site. Some of the heritage sites, they are not taken care of and are in a very bad shape. They are in a ruined condition. So this is the work of this organization, to bring up this heritage site and to preserve, like our Taj Mahal. So it works in, on it, that the, this cultural or world heritage site is maintained and they protect it. So it is the work of them to work for the educational and scientific development of the world, as well as you know, protecting the rich cultural and heritage sites of India. Like in Gujarat, we have many UNESCO sites, like we have the Pavagarh, we have in the Rani Ki Bhau, this bell, which is stepwells. In this way, these are our pride, our, you know, things to which we are proud of, and so we should protect them and take care of them. Okay? So UNESCO, United Nations Educational, Scientific, Cultural Organization, as well, by the name you can understand, it takes care of the education. It takes that the scientific development of the nations are taken care of, progressing. And headquarters is in Paris. It is established in 1946, and UNESCO was established in late 1945, and following the World War II, and when 44 countries met in London to discuss ways to restore the countries devastated by war. So after the World War, late 1945, they met and they decided, and it was formed. And now at present, the headquarters is in Paris. Coming to the next one, children, the United Nations Children's Fund. As you can see, the short form is UNICEF. It's an organization which works for the betterment of the children, works for children's rights, their development, protection and survival. Many a times, children are not privileged as you are. they don't have parents, or their parents are very poor, they have to work, they don't have proper food, they do not have even shelter. So in this way, these conditioned people are taken care of, the children's, their rights, their the right to go to school, you know, the right to education, the right to go to school, right to you know, have the proper meal and getting the proper medical treatment when they are sick, their development, their education, their protection. Even protection is very, very important. They should be taken care of, because children, many times crimes are committed against the children. So these things are taken care of. And its headquarter, children, is in New York. The UNICEF's headquarter is in New York. As you can see, a banner of UNICEF for children, works with the children all over the world. This agency helps children all over the world. It strives to provide free, compulsory and basic education to all children. So at least, not only for India we are talking about, not only for the poor nation, all over the world, the free education, at least the primary education to the children, improving their health condition, giving them nutritious food, aims at protecting children from violence. As I told you, many times crimes are committed against the children, that also they take care of exploitation and abuse of children. This again, this crime, different type of crimes against the children, this is how they fight against. And there is an organization which is all over the world, in each and every country, working for the children. These are the two main important agencies of the UN, the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, and the United Nations Children's Fund. Okay? So, thank you, children.